walking around Chicago downtown. So we're going to boat ride at Chicago River.
Well, the 1980s roll around, and I've kind of hinted at this idea that architects try to capture the cultural values of the decades in which they built. Well, the 1980s are very glamorous, and they didn't pay for it, nor the workforce to build due to World War II. So it's not until the 1960s that architects can show off what they've been working on in that gap of time. And if you look here to the right, just past this bridge, we now enter the common style of architecture from the 60s as expressed through these two black box structures, which stylistically is a complete reboot of design compared to Art Deco. Notice the eagle that drive 120 feet down to Chicago's bedrock, while also ascending all 747 feet to the top, which means right now before our eyes. But it also provides this moment from an engineering standpoint to witness just how our bridges operate. All you need when you pair them up with the counterweights, as together, it draws like a seesaw. Right, you'll notice those portholes with fans blowing out exhaust? That's from where our Metro and Amtrak trains run. So how do we get to accomplish this? Really, through two strokes of engineering genius we're going to appreciate together. Start by acknowledging that, ooh, there's that train going by, folks. Classic Chicago photo, make it a boomerang, a video, whatever. We built this river or canal that we're floating on today, which, if you're curious, is about 15 to 20 feet deep.